My name is Oleg Bortunov. I work in the Moscow University. I am a professional astronomer. I also am working in the Moscow POSRIS professional company. And today we'll talk about a new type of index access method called ROOM. Yes. I'm working with POSRIS about 21 years, and I've been working with GIST, GIN, SPGIST, HTOR, full-text search, JSONB, Trigram, and some other stuff. Many of them you already listened from Bruce's presentation. So today I will talk about our exercises of new features which was introduced in 9.6. Maybe you know that 9.6, you can create custom access method as extension. So we developed a new access method just to demonstrate the power of a new feature of 9.6. And also we did some useful thing which is good for the improving full text search. Here is the agenda. We will talk about why do we need full text search in database? Because I know that many people don't understand why we need a full text search in Postgres if we have already Solr, Lucene, Sphinx, and other external search engines. Then I will very briefly say about full text search in Postgres and outline some problems exist in full text search. Then I will talk about new features, about index access method ROOM, about phrase search, new type of full text search called inverse full text search, and very interesting example of how to search, how to combine full text searching with ordering by timestamp in one index. This is very useful, you will see. And if I have time, I will talk about dictionaries extensions, dictionaries in shared memory, and about editing functions of TS Vector introduced in 9.6. So what is a full text search? And full text search is a, you need to find document which match a query and sort them in some order. It's optionally. Why I said match a query? Because a query could be very complex. It could be a combination of logical operator, but some typical example is find documents which contains all words from query and return them sorted by relevance. This is a typical usage of full text search. Why we need? Because external search engines are very fast. They don't have any overhead of relational database. But external search engine can't index all documents because documents can be totally virtual. They can be result of very complex SQL operators, complex joins, and so on. It is impossible to index database. External search engine can don't have access to the attributes. So you can't create some complex queries. For example, you can filter search results based on roles, on groups, on users. For example, your boss can have access to all search results. Some anonymous users can have some different set of results. In external search engine, it's impossible because it has no access to the attributes. And also, external search engine introduced some overhead. It's they have to be maintained. I know some projects which has one database server and 16 database just for full text search. And DBA should maintain all these servers. This is a headache. Also, sometimes you need to certify the software. So you have additional overhead to certify external search engines. External search engines don't have instant search feature because they need time to fit to download new data and reindex. Sometimes it's very important. Once you upload document to the database, you won't instantly search it. Also, external search engines don't provide consistency. So you can find some results which already deleted from database. This is sometimes happens. So we have a needness for the full text search, which fully integrate with database engine. It does mean that it should support all transaction semantics. It should have a concurrency recovery, online indexing. Also, we want that search engine should have a extendability, and also it should be scalable. Traditional text search engine, text search operator, existed in Postgres from the very beginning. You know about this. It's like operators, but they have no linguistic support. They don't have a meaning of word, what to index. There is no relevance. So all documents in result have the same similarity to the query. You can't order them. And also, they usually slow because they use a sequential scan. And so it can be used, but it's not recommended for the production. And so we started developing full text search where from the beginning, the first version, it was at 2000. We use Postgres as a storage. So we index, we process documents outside using Perl programs and use Postgres just to store results of processing. And then we create gist index. So gist index was created specially for the full text search. Now gist is very popular for the other data. And we introduced tsearch first version in 2001. Then we introduced tsearch 2 in 2003. And in 2006, we developed gene index. So gene index, it's generalized inverted index, was introduced, was developed specially for the full text search. And we, in 2006, Enterprise DB sponsored the a full text search was became part of the Postgres core. In 2012, we introduced millisecond full text search. Some patches from this project were already committed to 9.4, but some still was not accepted by the community. And only now, in 2016, we were able to develop new full text search, new access method, because now we can do this create access method as an extension. So we don't need to patch the core. What is a full text search in Postgres? It's very easy. We have only two data types. It's a TS vector. It's a data type in optimized for search. It's actually the sorted array of lexemes. It has positions and some structural information. We have a TS query. It's a textual data type for query with support of some Boolean operator, so you can create very complex queries. And have a full text search operator, TS vector and for TS vector and TS query. Other are not very important, it's just accessories. And we have support of two index access methods, gist and gene. So the benefit of full text search in Postgres is that we process documents only once when insert document into database. So we have no overhead in search time. Document parsed, processed, converted, and indexed. And at search time, we process only query. the same process. We parse into tokens, tokens converted to LXM using pluggable dictionaries, and they could have labels, stop words removed from query, and also it's possible to create a very difficult queries, you can see. So full text search is a flexible search engine, but it is not just a complete solution, it is a collection of bricks. You can build your own search engine using custom parser, so you can write your own parser, which will understand what is a word, what is a LXM. You can write, use a custom dictionaries, so your dictionary will understand, it's just a program, it will convert your LXMs, your tokens to the LXMs, and use TS Vector as a custom storage. And plus, you have all power of SQL. For example, you can combine full text search with spatial, with temporal. For example, instead of textual documents, we can index chemical formulas. And I know such projects, they use full text search to process a chemical formula and index, and then you can easily identify some parts of chemical formula to find the documents which use it. Or I personally made some genome project used. We index human genome to find a mutation. So it's also possible with this full text search. Now we are going to discuss some problems. There are some problems in full text search. The first problem is it's that search is fast, but ranking is slow. If you see on this query, it's just 150,000 Wikipedia articles. You see that actually index scan is very fast. It takes just 6 milliseconds to find documents. But about 500 milliseconds takes to calculate ranking and order them. So we have an execution time. It's about half of a second, which is not very fast. All tests I made on this notebook. And this is a problem, because we need much faster results. Another problem is that there is no phrase search. So A and B is equivalent to the B and A. And if we analyze our mailing list archive, we can find only 92 posts with person Tom Good. But current full text search will find 34,000 posts, because you can see some Good Tom or different combination. But actually, only 90 posts was posted by this person. And we can use a combination of full text search with some regular expression, it works, but it's slow, and it is possible to express very simple queries. So this is also a problem. Another problem is that if you try to combine full text search with ordering, for example, by timestamp, you will have also some slow query. It's also about half a second, because it tried to use a bitmap index scan, then bitmap heap scan, and sorting. This is slow. This query show what Tom Lane was doing around millennium. Yes. And I especially choose Tom Lane, because Tom Lane is responsible for the 200,000 of postings in our mailing list archive. So this is a very, I would say, popular word, and good for the demonstration of the problem. Mm-hmm. So let's explain some internals of inverted index and Postgres. In any science book, at the end, you see the index. Index, which is a word and an array of number of pages where this word occurred. So this is actually is an inverted index. What we did, we convert LXMs into the, we store LXMs as a B tree. We called it entry tree. And for any, and we have a posting tree which store number of pages. So we have gene is a forest of trees. So we have Lexeme stored as a 1B tree, and for any entry in the leaf of this B tree, we have additional B tree. It's a gene, it's a, as Bruce said, it's very optimized for storing duplicates. So it's very ideal for the full text search because some popular words, they have a lot of posting, For example, stop word can be found in all documents. So B3 for this task is not good. Gene is very compact if you compare with B3. Yeah, so here is a picture, some schematically introduced gene index. If you don't know, gene is not generalized inverted index. First, our idea was to call it because of genie, you know. Genie is a magician who made everything. So when we developed this index, we recognized that it is very powerful, and we try to call it gene. In Russian, gene and genie is the same word. Yeah, so then we decided, okay, let's it will be gene, like generalized inverted index. And generalized means that gene index doesn't know which operation to speed up. It depends only from you. You write your op classes. So gene is like a template for the indexes. And that's why gene used very popular and can be used for many data types. For example, JSONB, HStore, they have a very good application of gene index arrays. So what we need? Our idea was to improve gene and by adding some additional information into posting tree. So we have a posting tree, you see the green. This is just an item pointer to the pages where the document live. We added some additional information. For example, we can add Lexeme positions, we can add timestamps or some other different information and use it for ordering results. So you see the item pointer becomes item pointer and additional information. This is our improvement. And this is what we introduced in 2012. Yes, but only 9.6, which opens Pandora box, I call it, because now everybody from you can create your own access method. You don't need to convince community to accept it. It's just up to you. You want to index internet addresses effectively. You know how to do this. You can do it. So this is a Pandora box. 9.6 have a custom access method, and it has a generic wow. So this custom access method will be citizen of it will have the same properties as built-in indexes. It can be have a concurrency, recovery, so it will be a first-class citizen of database. And we call it room. I don't know how to say why we call it room, because we have a gin, we have vodka, maybe you don't know, but we have also vodka access method, which is a our dream, and we have only prototype. We presented in Canada maybe 2 years ago. Yes, so we decided to call it room. Maybe it's a Russian method, a really useful method. Doesn't know. Yeah, just a name. So we add positions to calculate rank, and order results. And we introduce a distance operator. So distance between TS vector and TS query. And now with room, we can see the same slow query now have maybe about 9 times faster. Just because, as you see the explain, we have index conditions. Index conditions, it's a usual normal FTS, and order by text vector by distance. So we don't consult heap. Everything we do in index. And that's why we are getting 9 times faster here. This is very nice. For example, if we find a top 10 postings with Tom Lane, gene index gives us more than 1 second, gene index, and room index gives about 6 times faster also. Again, I think that is very good result for the room. Room used a new ranking function. Maybe you know that in Postgres we have 2 built-in ranking functions, TSRank and TSRankCD. But we introduced a new ranking function, so we call it TSScore, which is a combination of both of them, because TSRank does not support logical operator, but it's good. And TSRankCD works very bad with OR queries. But TSRankCD supports logical operators. It supports, use distance between words. So it's good. And we introduced new score function. You see that a bit different results. And to prove that this new function is good, we made a special research. We used here the graph for precision recall. We used a track ad hoc collections of documents, which is a number of, which contains a collection of documents, collection of queries, and a human-based ranking of these documents for each query. So we compare human results, how human believes that about relevance of documents to this to the specific query with our calculated. And here we tested several ranking functions, including TF-IDF, MySQL ranking functions for different AND and OR queries. And we found that our TS score is very good, and we use it. It combines all advantages of both ranking functions. But of course, as it's, you can write your own ranking function. It is just a C function. So now I think that we solved the problem with the speed. So we have a room index, which is good for ranking search results. And now we're going to the second issue, that about phrase search. Actually, phrase search we introduced 8 years ago. 8 years ago, we had a phrase search, but one of the problem is that with community, that you should convince community that it is good and should be accepted and so on. So 8 years, we did not have time to do this. Yeah, this is true for the democracy, you know? So you think that you wrote something interesting, but you should invest your time to convince people. And only now, only for 9.6, we did it. So now we have a phrase search with preserved order of words in query. So results for 2 queries, A and B and B and A, they are different. And we introduced one new operator followed by. It looks like a distance, but it guarantees the order of operands, and it has a distance between operands. So general way, you can specify the number of words between operands. Followed by operator can return false, and also it can return true and array of position of the right operand, which satisfies distance condition. And of course, it requires positions. So if you have a TS vector without positions, so it will return false. So here is some properties. Of course, that default value is 1. So and there is a very special case when we can have a zero distance. It's match the word with two different forms. Here is the example that bookings can have a morphological dictionary can return two forms, booking and book, for the same word. So we say that there is a distance of zero. It's a special case. Usually you don't need it. Precedence of TS query operators is what? Is this like here? And if you want to manage to control nesting of full text search operators, then better to use parentheses, because else you can have some undesirable results. You see the second and third queries, they look the same, but actually they produce different results. So it's normal. We have a phrase to TS query for the lazy people. It's you can write your yourself, but this function returns query already processed and stop words taken into account. So this phrase produce, you see that PostgreSQL extend, and you have a distance free. So because we take into account stop words. It can possible to combine TS queries, of course. Yes. And now there is some difficult part. It's some about internals, because phrase search, of course, introduce some overhead, because you should process results and use position. And we don't want to slow down full text search for normal operators like AND or they don't need position. So we transform query. The first query transformed to the different query. So we have a regular tree on the top, which don't need positions, and phrase tree, which requires position. So the upper query transformed to some another in the bottom. And we use this algebra for push down of a distance followed by operator down. So, and very interesting, the last two queries, when you say that there is no position of A followed by B. We transform the original form doesn't support index, of course. How to say it's not B. But after transformation, we have something that could be indexable. This is an example of transformation. And now we're going to examples of using. We have 1 million postings from Postgres mailing lists. You know that I downloaded archive from Postgres site. And again, we are looking for the Tom Lane. So Tom Lane is responsible for 222.77.7 postings. And using sequential scan, we can compare phrase operator and normal AND operator, plus some regex. So we see that there is an overhead. We have a 2.6 second for the phrase search and 2.2 for the traditional AND operator plus some regex. This is a result of processing results using and find and filter results. If we compare gene index, we see that there is also considerable overhead. Of course, it's faster, but still, phrase operator is slower than AND operator. So now with room index, we see that it is also faster than gene and then sequential scan, but overhead, so like I can say that there is no overhead. So room index solves the problem of some slowdown of phrase search. This is very good. Another problem, number three, how to combine full text search with ordering results by timestamps. Why we choose timestamps? Because it's very popular. Find something and order not by relevance, but by timestamp. So here is an example of a query. We want to see what Tom Lane was doing near Millennium. And if you remember, it was like a half of a second, and now we have a 85 milliseconds. Again, we have some speed up, considerable speed up. And this is very interesting case because in GenIndex, posting list ordered by item pointer. But here, posting list ordered by timestamp, which is was not easy technically to program. And you see the new syntaxes for the create index. We create index with FTS column and send. Send is a date, yes?
Can you pick arbitrary type of data type for the second part? Is it just timestamp?
Not yet. It's just the first version. But I understand people already asking us about supporting arrays, begin, and so on. Yes, we have plan. Yeah, but now you can specify what to attach to and use ordering or not. Actually, you don't need to order by timestamp. And we have also different operators. You can order by timestamp descending, so you can see the most fresh documents. We have a special, I don't know how to say in English, it's a distance operator, but to the left, you see. And for the Tom Lane, we got no speed up because Tom Lane is very popular, and for this query, you just use index by times by send, and then filter by Tom Lane, and because Tom Lane is very popular, result you can get very fast. So there is no speed up. But for example, for server crashed query, you get 10 times faster using Chrome. Another application of Room to full text search is the inverse full text search. Inverse full text search is it's a full query search. So you find queries which match given document. So it's inverse task. Sometimes it's very useful. Here is an example of automatic text classification. So you can classify queries. Yes, and Room allows you to speed up this such of queries. For example, we can, instead of storing positions or storing timestamps as additional information, we can store branches of query tree. As you already shown you query tree, so you can store branches and find efficiently resolve inverted task. So here is an example of how to find queries which match the very first message in Postgres mailing list. So this is a query, and real query from Postgres server. So I asked Magnus, he provided me a list of full text search queries, so I used them. And here is the two queries which match this message. It was posted by Mark Fournier, and the message was very short. It was about Postgres and FreeBSD. So here are the two queries. More interesting query is to find some monstrous postings. Monstrous, I mean that find postings which match the maximum number of queries. So you see that some postings match more than 4,000 queries. It's because the packages release notice. Of course, they are very long and satisfy many queries. So here is just an example what we can do with inverse full text search. So how to compare, now we compare room and gin. I use about 6 million classifiers with real queries, real life queries, and run queries in 24 threads for about 1 hour. So I just emulate the normal work of some web classified system. So with gin, we get quarter of a million queries processed, and with room we have a 7 times more. So room is very, it's really fast. You get a 7 times speed up. Room has no pending list, just not implemented. Pending list is used for the speed up of insert, and room also stores more data because it stores additional information. And here is a benchmark of insert 1 million messages to gin, to room, and to gist, some different kind, some options used. And we see that, of course, gist is fast, and optimized gin also is fast as gist, but room, it's slow, about 2 times slow, but as I said, it's slow because it's just bigger, it stores more data, so it's normal. Yes. The wall traffic is big. We see that we have about 30 gigabytes of a wall. If you compare with gist, which has only 3.5 gigabytes, and gin is about 10 gigabytes. So. But as I said, room has no pending list. So if we switch off support of pending list in gin, we also will have a 24 gigabytes of traffic, and it also will be a bit slow. So I believe that when we add support of pending list to room, we'll have more or less the same time for the room as gin.
If it
pending list is an optimization technique which allows gin to be fast for insert. So gin, it's a structure of gin, is not good for insertion. Because if you insert just one document which have 1,000 words, you need to insert 1,000 inserts. So it's the nature of gin index. So it's slow for insert. So what we did? We have a gin index and separate append-only storage. We call it pending list. So new data just appended to the storage. And at vacuum time, it converts to the gin, to the index. But at search time, you have to look at two places, in gin index and pending index. So it's a trade-off. If you have a read-only data, don't need to insert, you just but need a faster search, just switch off the pending list and you will have fast, you will be faster. But if you are looking for the compromise between insert and search, you use a pending list. Yeah. So again, room has the same problem, the same nature. So room is most useful for mostly for read-only data right now. But after pending list, it will be the same performance as gin. We also room generates a lot of wall traffic because we use a generic wall. We don't we use generic wall, which is a new feature of 9.6. And you see why? Because generic wall, the current version which was accepted by community, does not recognize shift. So if you insert new data, you see the green color, just a small data, but you have to wall all this data. Because current algorithm implemented in generic wall doesn't recognize shift of data. So that's why generic wall generates too big traffic. For example, for the example of mailing list archive, it generates 186 gigabytes of wall. Enormous, 186. Yes. So what we did? We did optimization. We just don't write wall when insert, but after creating index, we write at one shot the wall. This is very interesting technique, and we want to implement it for GIST, for GIN, for SPGIST, because it saves a lot of traffic. If you see on the table, we see that now we have, instead of 186 gigabytes of wall, now we have just about 2 gigabytes of traffic index. Yes. No, we have one and a half gigabytes of traffic. Very small. And create time also becomes very normal. So this is another our finding. And for new version, for the next version, we need to optimize generic wall so it could be usable for real application. So what we have is some to-do for room. We want to allow multiple additional information. For example, right now you can store lexem positions or timestamp. But what if you want to store both? So we want to add this possibility. We want to add op classes for array, for integer, for float, for it's like a any array. We want to improve ranking function to support TF-IDF. IDF is a traditional technique used for ranking in the external search engines. We want currently, room doesn't support prefix search. GIN, you know that GIN, in GIN you can use a prefix search, but in room we just did not implement it yet. Improved insert time, I said about pending list, and improved generic wall to support shift. But it's you can download it from GitHub for 9.6 and can play, and we need your feedback. Generic wall already is in core of 9.6.
With the shift?
No, without shift. I think that we will work on
for, I'm sorry.
Yeah, for 10.0. Mm-hmm. So this is, I don't know if I have time for the other slides, but this is my thanks to you. Yes, and okay, I have four minutes. So here is there is also another problem, number four. So working with dictionaries can be difficult and slow because you need to find where to get dictionaries, for example, Handspell, iSpell, and do something. Yeah, so, and dictionaries loaded into memory for every session. So sometimes people are very surprised when first query is very slow, and then it's fast. It because a dictionary should be processed, initialized, and also they eat memory. Here is an example of how it works. For example, for Russian Handspell dictionary, it took about 4 seconds to load. And each session, it's about 20 megabytes, which is not good. If you have 100 connections, it means that you have 2 gigabytes of RAM just for storing dictionaries. It's not good. So we did it, my colleague, and used some Thomas Wanderer version. They produce a shared spell dictionary. So you can load it to the shared memory, and so you save memory, and it's much faster. So you compare, you see, loading Russian dictionary, first queries takes about a fraction of second, if compared with about 4 seconds. So this is good for production. We use it. And dictionary as extension. We have a GitHub repo for hand-spell dictionaries for most for popular languages. So you can just have a create extension, and everything will be ready for using. Here is an example for hand-spell for Russian, English, Norwegian dictionaries, how it's used. Yes, so now it's easy. In 9.6, we have a bunch of TS vector editing functions. So we have some, I don't want to say about more, it's very natural functions, what to do, filter functions. What I want to say, the last, is that we have added multilingual support. So we introduce new join option for text search configuration. Here is an example for German-English configuration. So if you specify join for German hand-spell dictionary, then results of different dictionaries for different languages will be combined, joined together. And you can index multi-language documents and search. It's also available from the GitHub, and we hope that we will push it to the core, Postgres core. Yeah. So this is the last slides, and I have just 1 minute left. So please, your questions. Yes.
How's it going with vodka?
Vodka is a very nice concept. We just don't have time to invest to this project. Because when I was a freelance developer, I had time. But now we organize our company, Postgres Professional. We have some different priorities to work for customers. Yes, but we hope that we will return to this project. Every time we found the problem, we remember vodka, that vodka should solve this. Vodka should solve this. Yes, so don't worry. Sometime we will talk about vodka here.
how is vodka different than rum?
Huh?
What's the main idea of vodka?
Main idea of vodka is a infrastructure for combining in different access methods. For example, if you want 2 years ago, you want to combine full text search with spatial search. Find me a restaurant which is close to the so on. How to combine? We have already op classes for the R3, for example, for the GIST. We have op classes for the full text search. So vodka allows to combine them into one access method. Yes, trigram and so on. Very many different.
So it's a way of creating a new access.
Yes. From the available.
You can compose them.
Yes. Right now, Postgres, what you know Bitregist and Bitregin. Why we did it? Because Postgres doesn't support a combination of different access methods. So we have to do this. So with vodka, we don't need all this stuff. So. And for indexing non-structural data for JSONB, Vodka will be just excellent. And we are working on JSONB compression stuff, and we hope to show in the next conference that you know that JSONB currently is very good. It's still good performance. I compared recently with Mongo last version. We still have a very good results if you compare with Vodka, with MongoDB. But the size of JSONB is big because we store all keys in the in table, in the index. This is not good. So we now working on the dictionary compression. So we have a dictionary. We don't. We store only IDs, and JSONB will be very small and very effective. And how to and to index effectively, we also want to use, for example, the new room access method. I repeat that room was as example of testing of application of two very great features in 9.6. I think that it's like a sort of revolution, create access method and generic wow. Because this, one of the famous features, in my opinion, of Postgres, if you compare with other database, is its extendability. Extendability, because no other database can be extended as Postgres. But until 9.6, we have some problems. We have operators, data types, we can do many stuff, but we can't create access method. Now we can create access method as extension. And next step is create table engines. Then we have a full stack of extendability. And I hope for the 10.0 we'll show something for the custom table engines. So this is what I would say about indexing stuff, because Bruce said in the very short lecture about a lot of stuff, you know, Jin, Giz, Brin, yes, but he forgot to say that this is most famous feature of Postgres. Okay, my talk was a bit technical. These slides will be available on the site. You can download and read more detail to see explain, to see other interesting details. Any questions? I can say, I can answer to many different for JSONB, HStore stuff. You know that HStore we developed in 2003. So in 2003, Postgres was already has a support of semi-structural data. And if somebody told me that time that you need to implement JSON, yeah, there will be no Mongo. But that time there was no JSON. JSON appeared only in 2008. Yeah. And HStore was used so many applications. And now we have to implement JSONB to approach to Mongo. What is
you have a company, right? Postgres Professional. Do you have a special database, or is
that? Postgres Professional. We are working on the vanilla Postgres, on community version of Postgres. Last year we submitted 65 patches. Was committed to the core of Postgres, but also we have a fork. We have a fork because our customer they are asking for some new features. And they don't want to wait when community accept them. So we have to implement some features for them. But this is good because if we will succeed, for example, we developed 64-bit transaction support. because some of our customers, they don't want to have to take care about frequent wraparound problem. There are some projects that they have a wraparound every 4 hours. So for them, 64-bit transactions are very good. And if we find all obstacles of problems, of resolve all issues with this, we can show to the community version, say that, okay, please accept this 64 bits. Yeah, so we have fork.
Wasn't there a famous Russian search engine that converted to
PostgreSQL? Yes, Yandex is the biggest search engine and biggest service provider. It's, yes, it converts fully to the Postgres. This is very good sign for Postgres, because you now have reference to the very big, yes.
We're indexing about 400 gigs with ROM, just testing it out, 400 gigabytes of PDF files, which is fantastic.
Yes, yes. Yes, of course.
Fantastic on the speed. So you were mentioning in the timestamp and the lexeme on the posting tree, you'll be able to add any data type to that.
Yes.
Because I thought you said either or. You'll be able to add more than one attribute, for example?
Yeah, this is what I said in to-do, allow different additional information.
Right.
Yeah.
But I did like a text data type, for example.
Yeah. No, this is, for now, this is an exercise you can use already. But we learned a lot from this experiment. So
we use just joins to do order by, we order by a lot of different types besides relevancy. You don't have normalization yet. That was something I requested on GitHub. But we use timestamp by just doing joins. You know, it's still pretty quick.
No, it will be much quicker. Much quicker. And what's nice that here you have a stable result, because speed of your query very depends on the combination of if it's popular word or what's the timestamp you use. It's Postgres will choose different plans, and performance will be very, how to say, unstable.
Generally, we're doing a fairly complicated qualification and the text search. Like, he owns the document and he has not read the document. Like,
yeah.
Two things. This person owns it, this person has not, this lawyer has not downloaded it. It's owned by this lawyer, right? And it was loaded in the last 10 days. So, timestamp's just one of many things in the search they might do. And, you know, but it's just fantastic. It's been a guy, it's good stuff. It's amazing how many problems can get solved with a good text search.
Yes, especially I was very surprised with the chemical formula.
Yeah.
You know that there is a special notation for the chemical formula.
Right.
And it's so nice. you can write your own dictionary, which knows the chemical, you know.
Reactions.
You can find everything.
Yeah, it's very easy. It's very natural for people to.
Yeah.
Think in language, they don't think
just think about that it's not about language, it's about different.
Yeah.